Hi everyone, welcome to Wildix collaboration video tutorials. Today we talk about two-factor authentication, or simply 2FA. I'm sure you're familiar with it. Today many services offer it. Basically, it allows us to add an extra layer of protection to our account. With 2FA enabled, we need to provide two pieces of information to access our account. And first is something that we know, like our login and password. And second, something we have, like a code sent to us via SMS or generated by a third-party application installed on our mobile device. To enable two-factor authentication in Wildix collaboration, let's first click on the gear icon from the top menu to open Settings and select Personal on the left panel. Click on the pencil icon next to two-factor authentication. Here we have three options. Use the app that generates the code, like Google Authenticator, for example. Use SMS or use the email option. Just several notes before we try any of these. To be able to use the SMS option, SMS service should be enabled on your system. If you don't have any device or any service for SMS configured on your system, then you won't be able to use this option. Your mobile number should be present in collaboration settings, personal, and your email should be present there as well if you wish to receive the code via email. If you wish to use the app, you should first download and install one of these applications on your mobile device. Let's try the email option first. To enable 2FA with email, I need to select this option first and then click on Send Code. In a few moments, I'll receive an email with the code. Meanwhile, I'll enter my password here into the field Password. And here is my 6-digit code. Click OK. Now it's enabled. Each time I access collaboration, I receive a new 6-digit code via email and I need to enter it together with my login and password. Now let's try the option with the app. I've already installed Google Authenticator on my phone, so I select Application and I select Google Authenticator. I need to open the app on my phone and scan this QR code. Now the app gives me the code and I need to enter it into the field Code, and my password for collaboration into the field Password. Okay, now it's enabled. Let's give it a try. I enter my password and now I'm redirected to the page where I need to enter the 2FA code. I open the app, I find Wildix PBX and here is my code. What do you think will happen if for some reason you can't access your mobile phone and you can't get the code? Right. You will need to contact your system administrator and have your password reset. Still, we highly recommend you use the 2FA option because it adds extra protection to your account. Thank you for watching our video. See you next time.